We have three cylindrical pipes here. I'm going to attempt to use surfacing to create a blended transition between all three cylinders. First, let's talk about why lofting is not an option here. The loft command does not allow us to start from one profile and end with two separate profiles, or vice versa. We can create two or more lofts and attempt to join them together through a series of trimming and patching operations. But that is going to be challenging and tedious to create a smooth surface. I would recommend to approach this using the surface patchwork approach. Before we get into the tutorial, let's take a look at the finished model to identify these patches. There are two main types of patches or surface bodies here. If you look at the surfaces in red, they form links between two cylinders. Let's call these bridging surfaces. We will be building these surfaces first. The surfaces in green basically patch up the two openings after the bridging surfaces have been built. I will post a link to the file in the description below. Just roll the timeline back to the point just after the surface extrudes of the three cylinders. Before we begin, take note that the center points of these cylinders all lie along the right plane. We will be using the loft command to build the bridging surfaces. To do that, we need profiles. The profiles in this case will be a small section or an arc of the circular edge. We need to do a split face. Go to Construct, Offset Plane, and create an offset plane 20mm from the right plane. We shall use this offset plane as a cutting tool. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select all three cylinders as the faces to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the offset plane. Repeat the same steps to get the split lines on the other side. I would advise against using the mirror command here. When I tried that, it did not produce the split lines properly for the loft. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Loft. Let's try creating this bridging surface. The split lines created earlier have helped us to create this segment, which we can use as profiles. Select the two profiles. Set the Continuity option to Tangent for both. Since we have existing surfaces to take reference from, we can select them from the drop-down list. You can sketch a center line to get more control of the loft if you need. Repeat the same steps to build the other two bridging surfaces. Go to Create, Patch. Uncheck the Enable Chaining option and select the edges that lie along the boundary of the opening. Group all the edges and set the Continuity option to Curvature Continuous. This should give us a best transition. Next, we can mirror this surface body across the right plane. Stitch all these surfaces together into one single surface body. Going back to the previous step of creating offset planes, you will need to experiment with different amounts of offset here. Usually, the aim will be to adjust the offset to minimize a patch surface. I will leave that to you to try.